Now, you've likely been informed of the importance of controlling your chronic systemic inflammation, maybe through a variety of sources. And it's not a frivolous suggestion made up by healthcare providers, healthcare research, marketers, or advertisers. Rather, it's because there's so much science out there correlating how chronic systemic inflammation contributes to both the development and progression of a multitude of modern-day chronic illnesses. Now, you may have asked yourself, is there any way I can curb this, taper this, lessen this? Can I use food as medicine to help limit the impact of systemic inflammation on your health, on your wellness, and better control the amount of inflammation in your body? And the answer is, of course, you can use food as medicine. I always encourage you to use food as medicine. And you can do so in a variety of ways through making better, more informed decisions about your food choices. Now, what I want to talk about today is a class of compounds naturally occurring in plants called polyphenols. Now, maybe you've heard about the benefits of polyphenols. There have been multiple news presentations, multiple magazine articles written about the potential benefits of consuming more polyphenols in your diet. Consumed at high levels by those who eat whole foods diets, they've been shown to be primary mediators of inflammation with numerous health benefits. Interestingly, at least interestingly to me, one of the means by which they may accomplish this is through their special interactions with our microbiome. The microbiome is composed of those healthy, happy bacteria in our intestines. Now, one food source particularly high in polyphenol count is the pomegranate. Entire companies have been made famous for it. Pomegranate contains many polyphenols, including ellagic acid, ellagitannins, and quercetin. Like the apple, similar to the apple, the skin actually contains the highest amount of polyphenols, and when pressed to make a juice, those polyphenols are extracted. Now, the studies, the science behind pomegranate, actually pretty impressive. They can decrease blood pressure by a few points, decrease bad cholesterol by a few points, and improve the carotid intima media thickness. So the carotid artery is this very important artery that supplies blood flow to the brain, and improving the thickness means that it increases the blood flow up to the brain, which obviously is important. One study showed that 300 milligrams taken twice daily for 4 weeks showed improvement. Importantly, significant reductions were seen in oxidized LDL. And that's the real killer. It's not LDL, it's oxidized LDL, which causes damage to the arteries, which cascades into developing atherosclerosis. The study also showed decreases in both homocysteine and C-reactive protein. Homocysteine and C-reactive protein are both inflammatory markers, and so decreasing inflammation, a great idea. And the study showed improvements in blood sugar, blood glucose, and hemoglobin A1C. One pomegranate delivers nearly 30 milligrams of vitamin C, which is somewhere between 30 and 40% of the daily vitamin C requirements for most adults. Now, there's two compounds in pomegranates, punic collagens and punicic acid. And they're responsible for most of the health benefits of the pomegranate, the powerful pomegranate. Pomegranates also have high antioxidant activity. In fact, three times higher than that of both red wine and green tea. So, orally, historically, pomegranate has been used for high blood pressure, congestive heart failure, coronary heart disease, myocardial ischemia, so poor blood flow to the heart itself, atherosclerosis, high blood lipids or cholesterol, metabolic syndrome, rheumatoid arthritis, athletic performance, exercise-induced muscle soreness, muscle strength, parasitic infections of the GI tract. And it's also been used for obesity and weight loss, and as an astringent when used topically, for GI distress of all kinds if it's diarrhea or constipation. Other historical uses have included for chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, menopausal symptoms, influenza, erectile dysfunction, memory, and for promoting the growth of beneficial bacteria in the large intestine. Topically, pomegranate has been used for periodontitis, overgrowth of yeast in the mouth, hemorrhoids, and as a gargle for both sore throat, and as a rinse for dental plaque. Now, science has not been performed on each of these conditions, but it has for blood pressure, for cholesterol, and for blood sugar control. So at least that is impressive. More studies need to be done. Now here's a word of caution. Commercial pomegranate juice products may be adulterated to improve taste and color. Additionally, pomegranate juice is high in demand and short in supply, so some manufacturers may add other fruit juices to extend their supply. Fruit juices that may be added to pomegranate juice include apple, pear, grape, cherry, plum, and aronia, if you know what aronia is. To improve the color of poor quality pomegranate juices, natural grape pigments or highly concentrated aronia, blueberry or blackberry juices may be added. Non-pomegranate sugars may also be added to improve taste of poor quality pomegranate juice. Sometimes poor quality pomegranates can be a bit bitter, and so commercial companies really trying hard to advertise and market may add additional sugars to it. And standardization of pomegranate extract supplements based on their ellagic acid content does not necessarily guarantee pomegranate supplement authenticity, purity, potency, as supplements may contain ellagic acid from less expensive plant sources. So pomegranate as a whole, actually a pretty impressive fruit, but there are some standards that you want to live by. I like to use the real pomegranate, cut it in quarters, juice it myself, because both vitamin C and those polyphenols can break down with storage over time. So I like to use real pomegranate, juice it, have it a few times a week to make sure that vitamin C and polyphenol content are what I want them to be. So I'm with Zenith Labs. We have a website, zenithlabs.com. I encourage you to check that out. I encourage you to subscribe to this channel, like it, share it with your friends and loved ones. We post several times a week to help better inform you about your health and wellness. I want to take this journey together with you. We have an Instagram page, a Facebook page. Become involved, because the more you become involved, the more you will be better informed about your health and your wellness. Thanks so much for your time and attention. Dr. Ryan Shelton.